All right.
Welcome. I missed you. We're making Brussels sprouts again with potatoes, a little bit of rice, but guess what? Filet mignon, baby. Filet mignon. And of course, we are searing this baby like it's never been seared before. Be right back. Okay, so quickly, I drizzled some salt. I found this in Marshall's, so why not? And it's basically for veggies. It says roast veggies and fries, spice blend. So we're gonna do that. We're going to put some pepper, of course. We're going to put some olive oil. Where's my olive oil? Okay, I like to use this one. Okay. And that's pretty much it. Oh yeah, I like to put rosemary. And then I told you guys that I also like to drizzle a lemon. The pepper always gets to me. So, I'm gonna take a lemon that I have, and we're just gonna squeeze that. Okay. And now we'll toss all this goodness and we're gonna throw it in the oven at 400 and it's gonna bake. Later on, I'll put some butter on top of all this. Be right back. Okay, so with the Brussels sprouts, I'm basically doing the same thing. The only thing different is that I went ahead and added some chili flakes. But it basically has all of the same, and I'm just gonna go ahead and add the olive oil, but not too much. That should be enough. And now we're gonna toss that around. You know what I forgot on the potatoes, but I can do that when I'm gonna put the butter, the garlic. So I am gonna put some garlic powder here. Here's my garlic powder, right here. I'll be right back. Sorry I didn't show you the potatoes, but these are the Brussels sprouts. Okay. And now they're going.
Okay, so now we're gonna do the rice. My pot is nice and hot. I'm gonna go ahead and pour the oil based on the amount of rice that I'm gonna be cooking. I like to measure it with these little containers that I've shown you guys before. So the way I wash it, I basically just do one of these, and then I rinse that out like so, and then that's it. So I basically put my salt in the middle. My pot is nice and hot, so I will go ahead and throw this rice. Well, I guess it wasn't that hot because it didn't sizzle. I had it on before. I thought it was still. But no worries. And then basically right away, no shame in my game, I'm going to put the same measurement of rice that I had right in there. And that's it. I'm done. I'm going to rinse this out and let that boil, dry up, and then cover it for a good 20 minutes. So that's all synchronized with my potatoes and my Brussels sprouts. And now we're gonna work on this filet mignon. Be right back. So my filet mignon has sea salt and it has pepper. And I also have fresh garlic right over here that I'm about to grate. And then we're gonna use the good butter, which let me show you. Where's my butter, my fancy butter? So we're gonna be using this butter. Okay, guys. Yeah. Okay, so I want to make sure you understand that on this filet mignon, we are only going to put some grated fresh garlic, some salt, and some pepper, and then, of course, your good quality butter. Okay, so I basically took out the potatoes, and I'm chopping up a little cube of butter, and I'm just cutting it and throwing it back inside, because they're not done, but I do want them to have that little juiciness on them.
Be right back.
So my pot is hot, and I'm throwing in the butter. The pieces that I have are quite small. Let me show you. Three little ones like this. The other ones are a little bit smaller, and then this one. I'm gonna make sure that my pot is nice and hot. Throw the butter in there so that we can just start searing. By the time this is done, our rice should be done as well. And I'm gonna cook it how I want to eat it. I don't like to see any blood. That's what we're gonna do here. See you right back. Okay, so the rice is covered, the veggies I'm about to take out, the steak is nearly done. Actually, I did stop it already. And then we went ahead and make, and I want to show you this pack of cucumbers. They're actually really, really tasty, really, really good. I love cucumbers. So I went ahead and I made a salad with simply freshly grated garlic, salt, pepper, lemon juice, and olive oil. That's pretty much it. And it has tomatoes, onions, and the cucumbers. Really, really good. And what I'm going to do is that since this is well seasoned already, I have an avocado, and I'm just gonna pour all this goodness over the avocado. I'll be right back.